tribute to both Connors and Filas. Sets are one all.
You know, Pat, throughout this championship, we really haven't had a lot of close matches. And certainly not later in the tournament, where quarterfinal, semifinal matches were won fairly handily. So the people are loving this one.
Well, I certainly haven't had a five-set match.
You got to hand it to Vilas. He was being pushed around and dominated. Appeared to be a little flustered late in the first set, but he hung in there. Finally got his service break and won the second set.
You see, that happens so much.
Yeah, you make that long run and then you sort of peek to see where you want to hit the ball instead of making up your mind in advance and just watching the ball. Vilas has served two aces, two double faults. Connors, one ace, one double fault. You don't expect to see many aces. Thought we might have a few more double faults because of the gusting wind.
First game of the third set. Vilas won the second set 6-3. Connors won the first. I was looking at the t-shirt. Vilas serving at love one in the third set, waiting for the crowd to settle down. Shadows again stretching across the court. The lights are already on. Pretty obvious by now that this is going to still be being played after dark.
Vilas broke a string. Now in this case, he does not get two serves. He only gets his second serve when he comes back. In other situations, when there's a delay, you hear him checking the tension.
Sounded like he'd like the one with the tighter string.
Right.
Second service.
He has an ample supply of rackets over there. It looks like 8 or 10 to me. So I don't think he'll run out.
No.
That's out.
15. Love.
Seems to me, Tony, he's given Connors more spin serves than the smoke that he had so much success with earlier.
Well, it's tough to get that smoke in all the time, Pat. And some people have had success against Connors when they've made him make the pace. Connors hit a ball either on or very close to the baseline in that rally. The crowd reacted. Those that were hoping it was out. Vilas took a little peek, but made no reaction whatsoever, so you got to assume that it was good.
Looked like it hit the inside of the line because it bounced almost straight up. There was the hard serve.
15-30.
And there it is again. Ace number three from Vilas.
I have a friend in Detroit named Ben Bidwell. He calls his first serve Big Smoke. Now he knows what Big Smoke is. His is Little Puff. That was some giant of a shot there.
I played golf with him. He says he calls you Big Smoke.
There's some more Big Smoke.
That's Little Smoke right there. Enjoying a foot long.
Boy, that looks good.
Sure does. Been a long time between meals, hasn't it? 40-30. Vilas trying to get even at one all in the third set. Sets are one apiece. Promise you that those shadows are a problem for both players right now, because that ball looks like it comes at you in dots and dashes as it comes through the shadow and then the sunlight. They'll be much happier when the entire court is covered with shade.
Score is deuce.
And it's break point for Connors.
Advantage, Connors.
Gives you a good idea of the shadow and the sunlight.
That serve comes from Vilas. It comes from the sunlight into the shadows, but when it comes back, it's just as difficult to see. Out of the shadows into the sunlight.
It's deuce.
Break point for Connors.
Advantage, Connors.
Pat, sometimes that net ball works in your favor and sometimes it works against you. That time it hurt Vilas because his ball came up short and higher. Gave Connors a good swing at a ball from near the service line. Connors measures it, rips it, then comes forward. He got the floater, and he knocked off the volley. So Connors leads 2-0 in the third set.
Vilas hit that ball with that chop swing, the underspin backhand, and it hung up there nicely for Connors.
Underspin basically wants to climb, wants to come up.
Again, Connors putting on the pressure.
15, love.
Vilas was in the same situation. That time he tried to hit a topspin return, but missed it. That's out.
15, all.
Thank you.
Say 15.
You get the impression that Vilas is doing a lot more running than Connors?
Yes. Of course, you normally have to do that against a guy that hits the ball as hard as Connors does because he's the aggressor most of the time. Vilas would be more aggressive, you know, and he is when he gets a shorter ball. I'll tell you this, Vilas is prepared to go five sets of running if he has to. And so is Connors. Aggressive play by Jimmy Connors takes him out to a 3-love lead in the third set.
Connors leads 3-0 in the third set. Sets are 1-1. It's the best 3 out of 5 final.
If you're on Connors' side, you say, well, that looks like a big lead. If you're on Vilas' side, you say, that's only one service break. Hold serve, get a break, hold back, and I'm even. I have to laugh, Pat, because I keep watching Tyriak. In previous matches, he has given Vilas a lot more instruction. But when you're playing Connors, who's sort of beating your brains out and hitting it real hard, you know, Vilas will look, and Tyriak takes a puff on his cigarette. What are you going to do? What do you say? Hang in there.
Keep trying.
That's right. You know Vilas is going to do that.
Let it. Second service.
Well, Vilas is 1 point away from getting on the board in this third set. Hammond responds to the reaction of the crowd. He puts his fingers about 3 inches apart and say, that was way out.
Out! Out. 40, 30.
Connors really moved in on that second serve. He's right back of the service line. Took it on the rise. Here he comes.
Vilas has held his serve.
Game for Mr. Vilas. Three games.
And that's the story.
Mr. Connors leads third set.
Don't forget, this is the best of five sets. Early in this tournament, it was two out of three. At the quarters, they started playing three out of five. We've got a ways to go yet. We'll be with you right to the end.
Out. 15, love.
Connor's looking at Vilas doing his little dance.
There was a lady, excuse me, Pat, lady walking around behind, up above, and she sat down very quickly when she felt his stare. Good play by Vilas. Pulled Connors out of position, was able to block that volley into the open court, no pressure.
He's down a service break.
That's a winner.
Oh, that's a winner. And a beauty it was.
Watch Vilas come in. He likes to close in real quickly. He keeps running forward, and you see he spun his wheels a little bit trying to stop and get back. Of course, you have to have a little bit of talent to be able to hit that lob like that. 30-15. That's out.
Connors had the whole court. He hit a great first serve.
Yeah, he sort of went under that ball, and it floated over the baseline. You see Vilas, he's not showboating at all. He's trying to get himself pumped up, keep those legs loose, get it going.
Looks like he's been doing some road work.
That's easy to do, and you'll watch Connors hit the top spin lob, and it comes down more quickly. You combine that extra spin with a little wind, and she just came down a little too fast, or faster than Vilas had anticipated. And it's 40-30. Connors trying to stretch his lead to 4-1 in the third set. The breeze has picked up again. Connors keeps looking at Vilas. So I'll wait till he quits bouncing up and down, then I'll serve. That goes out. The defending champion, Jimmy Connors, now has a service break and a 4-1 lead in the third set. Sets are one apiece.
Connors won the first set 6-2, Vilas the second 6-3, and Connors leads 4-1 in this set. Connors, I notice, just got from the trainer some kind of a something to help him breathe a little bit. He's had trouble throughout this tournament. I don't know if it's an allergy or a cold.
Sort of like an inhaler.
Yeah, I'm inclined to think it's an allergy because I've seen a lot of people and talked to a lot of people who've had it. And Connors is pointing underneath the canvas back of Vilas, saying some people were lying down back there, peeking underneath, photographers or whatever.
Amateur photographers.
Mm-hmm.
The ones with badges right on the side of the court.
And there are a lot of those.
The court is now in complete shadow, and that has to make it easier for both players.
And the lights are on and have been for quite some time. The sun will be completely down behind the stadium in a few minutes. And it's going to start to get cold. It's already cold.
Colder.
Colder.
Left.
Left.
You know, Pat, we ought to salute the ball boys and ball girls and the lines people, but these kids are out here every day, day and night, do an absolutely super job. I hope it's been a good experience for them, and I hope that the players have been good to them. From what we've seen here, they have, but they have done a marvelous job. They're unsung heroes as far as I'm concerned. The way Connor's hair is being blown around, that gives you an idea of the gusty breeze that's at court level. Watch this one, because Connors almost missed this overhead. Vilas way out of court. Now, when he makes this lob, you'll see that Connors hits this overhead very short in the court. He really mistimed it. Help of the wind, but he fortunately got it over the net. It is 15-30. Break point for Connors. He already has one service break in this set.
Seconds to allow our local stations to identify themselves. Guillermo Vilas serving in the far court.
Ball.
That's fault. Connors leads 4-1 in the third set. Sets are one all. Score is deuce in this game.
If we can get a close-up of Vilas as he gets up ready to serve, we'll take a look at his left arm, his forearm, and you'll see what exercise does for your body. Now look at the size of his left forearm. Willie Pose is now getting ready to start, and then take a look at the forearm on his right arm. Little difference?
Service. He is still, however, down a service break.
And he went over to get a towel, and Turiak had a quick comment to make to him.
He looks at him throughout the match. There's Tyriok back there. I keep expecting to see him coming, walking out of the fog somewhere.
He's gotten another pair of shoes out of a bag, so perhaps he's going to have Vilas change shoes at the end of this game at the court change. A winner.
Outright.
Point made reminded me sort of a prize fight when guys were coasting a little bit. It looked like they were both hitting a little more casually, almost resting, and Connors really didn't take an extra good swing at that ball. But it was good enough for a winner.
30 love.
Shot by Vilas.
40,
didn't have much on it. That gave Connors a chance to get ready, pick his spot, and he hit a four in up the line with too much pace for Vilas, and it's 40-15. If Connors can hold serve, he'll lead 5-2 in his third set. Sets are one apiece.
Adrian Clark talking with Connors. Connors drew a circle, but I think what Adrian said was, you hit it.
Connors scrapes the mark out. We've seen him do that before on both sides of the court.
Yeah. He did that against Barazzutti on Barazzutti's side. Did you see Corrado's comment, what he said about Connors doing that?
What was that?
He said, if he can do that, is there anything he can't do? If they let him get away with that.
Here's part of that point again. You'll see Vilas, when he starts to attack, his approach shot hits the top of the net. Right there, it takes some speed off and lets the ball bounce up. But Connors missed the two-hander going cross court, and it's deuce. Jimmy taking a little bit extra time now. He let a lead get away in this game. He doesn't want to lose the serve and lose the break back.
Connors.
All right, now you see Connors' approach off a short ball, hits inside the service line. His approach was not deep.
Advantage, Vilas.
And it made Vilas' job easier, and it's now break point for Vilas. He is down a service break in this third set.
Thank you.
break.
The roar of the crowd tells you that Vilas made the backhand up the line. He has broken back. It's 4-3 Connors in the third set. A good close match and well played by the contestants. And that's what we're watching now.
Guillermo Vilas on the left and Jimmy Connors on the right. Vilas serving to try to get even. He's down 3-4 in the third set. The sets are even. 1-1. Connors won the first, Vilas the second. So that's where we are.
And as far as he's concerned, he is even right now because he got the service break back and he's serving at 3-4. Now we got some people walking down by the photographers. Right down below us, walking in front of the photographers.
We've got more photographers than they used to have at the championship. On both sides of the court. Somebody says, come on, let's go. And he'll be hooted down, I hope.
Care who you are, Pat. If somebody hits that ball near that baseline with any kind of pace on you, you've got an awful tough time to make a passing shot.
Something blew out on the court. Connor said, wait a minute. Then Vilas did. Amazing how that ball that Vilas mishits dives back down into the court.
Well, it has extra topspin. You know, we kid around. I play hit and giggle out in L.A., and a guy mishits one. I said, well, you paid for the wood, too. You might as well use it, you know.
Hit and giggle. There's Tyriac behind us.
Whoops.
That one won't come down.
He used that wood again.
Yeah.
15-30.
Because Connors was not trying to hit that. There's Pancho Segura. Now, when Connors comes in, he was not trying to hit a drop volley. Vilas really ramrodded one at him. Connors takes a pretty good swing at it, but mishit it. And it dropped short. And now look at Vilas. He's saying, you lucky character. Or something like that.
Yeah.
Double break point for Connors.
Vilas got the good serve in, and Connors hit it out. A minute ago, you saw Pancho Segura clapping encouragement to Connors. Everybody has a guru these days.
Still break point.
That's the serve that Vilas wanted. And this one's tough.
Connors might try to jump on it and come in. Let's see. So Vilas has saved two break points.
Yes.
You know, when you think how long these two players will be out here, one of them's going to be disappointed when it's over. and how close it is, how one shot at the right time can turn it around. It was long. The volley was over the baseline.
This tennis and these two guys are so good, I think, Tony, we'll all be disappointed when it's over.
And the way they're playing, it's going to be one of those deals where you hate to see someone have to be a loser. Break point again for Jimmy Connors. Another good serve by Vilas. What a lovely weapon to have at your disposal.
Yes. Pulled him way wide. Sets are one all. Vilas serving at 3-4.
And now Vilas has the advantage.
Advantage, Vilas.
He keeps rubbing that ball on that grip. It's not Gaylord Perry. He's not loading it up. He's just
well, it's not illegal either.
Get the grip dry.
Try to go down the center line, and almost did.
Hit by Vilas.
Yes.
Connors hit a good deep return.
Both these guys have got that lead tape across the top of the racket. Put a little bit more weight in the head of the racket. Vilas seems to be taking a little bit more time on his serve,
and it's paying off.
He's gotten some big ones in this game. He has served four aces and two double faults. Connors one ace and one double fault thus far. Slowing the ball down two or three times. He took some pace off. He finally gets a short ball, and the kind of shot he misses more often than any other, the short approach shot. He catches the tape. The crowd erupts, and it's four all in the third set, and we've got a five-set match. This is not a three-set match, so we've got plenty of tennis left for you.
They've been playing about 2 hours and 15 minutes now. Oh, it didn't come over. It looked like it might, and then it fell back on the other side.
I think it's safe to say that near us on the left is someone that's pulling for Vilas, and he speaks his language. Gonna have to give him a tranquilizer.
Or get him a microphone. Oh, what a stretch by Connors.
That's another way to keep him down. Yeah, take a look at that again. Good stretch.
All.
Good stretch and good crisp volley here by Connors. And Vilas put the brakes on early because he knew there was no way he was going to get back and get that one. It's 15 all. four all third set. Sets are one apiece.
Connor's back cross court.
You know, how does he make that and then miss that easy approach shot? He's a human being, but it's really interesting. Amazing how that stadium quiets down.
That's going to be out.
Connors held his serve comfortably. He has a 5-4 lead in the third set. This is a best of five sets for the U.S. Open Tennis Championships. Watch two great tennis players play a super point. Bingo.
Love 15.
Smash right up the middle. Vilas rolls it back, and Connors hits a drop volley from behind the service line. Vilas gets there, and Connors closes back in and knocks off a winner. Another super point. 15-30. 4-5, third set. Each player has won a set. Jimmy Connors.
15-40.
Both players just hitting the ball as hard as they could.
But Connors getting better length on his shots than Vilas. Almost every one of Vilas' shots landing around the service line. It cost him.
He pulled another ace out. And that's number five. Still set point.
Not a bad time to reach back and throw that high hard one, huh? Down set point. See if he can do it again. It's still set point.
That's long.
Court.
That is a disgruntled Pancho Segura. You just saw the left-hand part of your picture.
Yes.
Vilas is saved. There is Tyriac in the middle, wearing black, which is appropriate. Vilas has saved two set points, and it is deuce. Man, you could cut this tension with a knife.
Oh, let's don't try.
To get even at five, all in the third set.
Don't forget it was double set point. And Vilas has come back. In the third set.
Game for Mr. Vilas. Games are 5-all.
It's becoming more and more apparent that we're going to have to stay on after our scheduled time of 7 o'clock, which we will do. Nobody will miss anything, however, because the whole network programming will slide. You understand that?
I think so. Uh-oh, that's the first drop shot.
First time.
We've been out here 2.5 hours, and that's the first drop shot we've seen attempted, and it was at a poor time for Connors. He's now down love 30. This is letdown time, Pat. You've got to really be careful.
And all of a sudden, the commander changed hats. It is now Vilas.
40.
Isn't it incredible?
It
Connors
really
had
is.
Two set points, and now he's down triple break point.
Up by one in the third set. He leads 6-5. Sets are 1-all in this championship.
Remember, if we get the 6-all, 12-point tiebreaker, we'll decide the set. A foot fault call, but he missed the serve anyway. And that is the third double fault for Vilas.
And the second foot fault that's been called against him.
Man, you might as well stand back 3 or 4 inches. Why take a chance putting that foot that close to the baseline?
Boy, he's got his toe right up there.
Good shot by Connors.
Love 30.
Love 30. Look how close that foot is. If he turns that toe, he can touch. And it's now triple break point for Connors.
Love 40.
This would put us into the tiebreaker. Connors will try to take the second serve, hit it, and come in behind it. He's done that a few times with success. He's got it!
The winner, look at Segura. And his mother, Gloria Connors, yelling encouragement. We'll go into the tiebreaker in the third set. A 12-point tiebreaker it is.
Game for Mr. Connors.
First
six all
player to seven.
We'll now play the 12-point tiebreaker.
Well, listen. Connors will serve first.
He serves 1 point, and then Vilas will serve two, and then Connors two. That's done so that if each player held all their points in their serve, one server wouldn't have 2 points in a row to win the set.
Boy, doesn't it give you a great feeling just to be able to sit and watch an event like this?
I should say.
And to be a part of the coverage. Not just you and me, I mean everybody that's associated.
Well, I should say, cameramen, technicians, all the guys in the truck.
I guess with all that equipment that's out there, we should say trucks. Blimps and what have you.
Couldn't get that two-handed volley away from Vilas. He tried the topspin overhead that almost got over his head. Jimmy stretched out completely and hit it short. Now, Vilas came up and just ripped the backhand, and Connors blocked the volley into the open court. We didn't see that part of it. Connors now serving at 1-2. After 6 points are played, the players will change ends.
Vilas in the tiebreaker.
And Vilas slipped back behind the court to grab a towel, to towel off his racket. He gave you that Ali shuffle. Short return by Vilas. Connors pulled it off sharply for a winner.
3-2 Vilas.
Sets are one all. We're in a tiebreaker in the third set. Sun is down behind the stands now, behind the stadium. Lights are on. Frank Hammond looking right down that service line.
That time, Connors was looking for the backhand passing shot cross court, and he nailed it.
It's three all now. They'll change ends without stopping.
Supposedly. They both grabbed a towel. They grab a drink. They're not supposed to do that, but both are doing it. I don't think the umpire, John Coleman, will say a thing.
So it's three all in this tiebreaker. Vilas and Connors in the finals and the finals in this stadium.
If mom's got dinner waiting for anyone here, you better put it on the back burner. We're going to be here a while. No one is leaving.
Vilas attacked and won.
Almost a surprise because Vilas does not come to that that often. He made a good approach. Blanketed the net and blocked that forehand volley in the open court.
4-3 Vilas. Five, three, Vilas.
5-3 Vilas.
Remember, the first one to get to 7 with a 2-point advantage wins the tiebreaker. Vilas has 2 serves, 2 points, and has a chance to run out the set. If he can win these 2 points, he wins the set.
He starts serving in the ad court.
A little gamesmanship going on right here. Connor's looking at his strings, waiting, making Vilas wait.
And now Bugs. And Vilas steps out of the batter's box.
Right, now that was not. That's something, a moth or something flew by, so Connor's had to get him out of the way. Or her. I don't want to be chauvinistic.
Took a look. His return hit the top of the net and almost crawled over.
6-4 Vilas.
Jimmy's not arguing, so I think he must know it was good. He's shaking his head, yeah.
He looks down the line at Adrian Clark.
And it is set point for Vilas.
Four.
Perfect topspin lob by Connors.
Love 15.
Another miss hit that came down good.
Now that's the interesting thing. Why does Connors look for a backhand up the line when up to this point, Vilas has hit almost every backhand passing shot cross court? Whatever the reason, Connors was there, made the drop volley successfully, and it's love 30.
In some fashion, he must be able to read it. Although Vilas beat him cross court three or four times earlier. Oh, good serve.
Well, he went five times into the same part of the court and finally won the point.
15-30.
Connors comes out of the corner and Vilas goes back again. He's got to put on the brakes. He throws up the lob. Now, which way do you go to cover the smash?
Would you have let it bounce?
Yes, sir, absolutely. The last time we had a five-set final here at Forest Hills was 1973 when John Newcomb defeated Jan Kodish 6-4, 1-6, 4-6, 6-2, 6-3. We might be staring at a five-setter right here.
First game of the fourth set. Vilas is up 2-1 after having won that third set in a tiebreaker. Smoke and serve from Vilas. And he holds serve. And the first game of the fourth set. This is for the United States Open Men's Singles Championship. And boy, what a good match it is. No delay in that. Connors and Vilas. That ball is out from Connors. Sets are 2-1 Vilas, and he leads love 1 in the fourth set. Look at that shot.
Looks like Cincinnati to me.
Looks more like New York to me. Although I haven't seen all of it.
But most of it.
A fag.
Yep.
It's also very cool this evening in New York. I would guess with that mysterious thing they call the windshield factor, it's close to 50. It's been breezy all day.
Yep. 40-15.
Connor is 1 point away from getting even at one game apiece in the fourth set.
Vilas does that dance before every serve. Couldn't get there. He was holding that racket straight down when he made that volley.
We'll take a look at it again. Connors tries to roll a little ball short, soft, but he didn't get it far enough out, and Vilas just ripped the back and up the line. Now Jimmy's flat out to get to it and make a shot. Tough volleying attempt by Vilas. He got it short. Connors couldn't get there. 40-30.
That's going to be good, and so is that.
Not only so is that. What a shot.
What a shot.
Let's enjoy it. This looks like it's going to be a winner. It is deuce. And it's now break point for Vilas.
Advantage, Vilas.
Connors.
Yes.
Here's how Vilas gets to another break point. And now Connors is doing the running. Vilas closes in and makes the good crisp volley. Back to live. Some noise disrupts Connors.
Connors says, sit down, lady.
Call this a sissy sport.
Sunset now just over the city, that tallest building, of course, is the Empire State Building. And the other one, with the point on top, is the Chrysler Building.
This is break point for Vilas. He's got it.
Good, he's got it. I'd remind you again that we are going to stay with this until its conclusion. But 60 minutes. And all of the other programs on CBS tonight will be seen in full.
And Mrs. Connors on the right and Pancho Segura on the left, obviously concerned and worried at this point as Vilas has broken serve. He leads 2-love in the fourth set. He has a 2-set-to-1 advantage.
We now pause 5 seconds to allow our local stations to identify themselves. The sunset again over Manhattan. Over behind there is the Hudson River. The interest, though, is right here.
Good return by Connors.
13-all.
Pat, you recall a little earlier I was saying that Vilas was making his passing shots off the backhand cross court. Connors finally started to cover them, and now the last two or three has gone up the line.
For those of you expecting 60 minutes at 7 o'clock Eastern Time,
first service,
it'll be delayed so that we can bring you the conclusion of this match, this finals at Forest Hills, but you will see it. You'll see 60 minutes in its entirety,
15.
Immediately following the conclusion of this, and also all the other programs on CBS tonight. They'll all be seen in full. We'll delay just until we finish at Forest Hills.
30-15. Serves a let. Connors won the first set 6-2. Vilas came back and won the second set 6-3. He won a third set 7-6 in a tiebreaker, winning that tiebreaker 7-4. He has a 2-love lead in the fourth set and a 30-15 lead.
An ace from Vilas. That's number 6. Going into this match, neither player had lost a set in this tournament. Now Connors has lost 2, and Vilas has lost 1.
By Connors, flips up in the air, and Vilas got his racket on it, but couldn't get it back into play.
30.
It's now 40-30. Vilas still 1 point away from taking a 3-love lead in the fourth set. Thank you. has held his serve. He has taken a 3-love lead in the fourth set. He has one service break. He leads 2-1 in this best-of-5 set final.
Will sort of slip back its regular programming tonight. There is Chrissy Evert, the women's champion, still watching. Vilas knocks off a winner. Connors might have broken a string. He's headed over to the side. CBS will present 60 Minutes in its entirety wherever you are. And the rest of the schedule as well. But it'll be seen at the regular time on the West Coast. CBS Sports will stay right here till the conclusion of this match.
And Vilas is pumped up. All. 15 all.
What a final.
30-15.
You know, you look around this stadium and not many people have departed.
As cold as it is. Call a fault.
That's going to be out.
30-all.
Well, I'll tell you what, that left-hander right there better turn the screw right now, because if he loses this serve, he's going to be in a whole bunch of trouble.
He is, of course, the defending champion. He said at the beginning, it's my title, they got to take it. There's a guy out there trying pretty hard.
He's made it. And it is break point. Vilas runs back, and there is Chrissy Evert. That tells a story.
Pretty much tells you who she's rooting for, too, doesn't it? That guy right there. Fourth set. If you're a fan of the defending champion, he's in trouble. There he is. Connors came out like thunder in the first set. He won it 6-2 and was in total control.
He sure was, and he was overpowering Vilas. Vilas was not having a chance to make decent strokes. And Vilas hung in there, and he was really on the ropes in the second set, but he finally got a break and managed to win the set, and it's turned around. But don't count Connors out.
Not yet.
Left.
You know, Pat, if this is the last match
first service
at Forest Hills for the U.S. Open, what a way to go out.
Whew. I'll say. Strong serve from Guillermo Vilas.
15-all.
We're now past 7 o'clock. We've been on the air since noon today. We were over 7 hours yesterday, over 30 hours of coverage of this championship. Another powerful serve.
Again, Chris Evert. She's been there. She knows what it's like. C- Connors has won this championship twice. He is the defending champion, as Pat mentioned. Vilas has never been in the finals of the U.S. Open before.
You know, while we were thanking people before and saying how great it was to be a part of this coverage, I forgot to mention Jimmy Wall, our stage manager.
Oh, yeah. What a man.
Part policeman and part stage manager up here for us.
Vilas 1 point away from going up to a 5-love lead in the fourth set, and he has a 2-set-to-1 lead.
Ball.
I bet for Connor's sake, it's nice not to see that first one come in. He's almost knocked the racket out of his hand.
Held his serve. He leads 5-0 in the fourth set. He is ahead 2-1. This is the U.S. Open singles finals.
Vilas leading Connors 5-love in the fourth set, and he has won 2 sets. It's a best 3 out of 5. Connors serving. Talk about being pumped up. Vilas. Now 3 points away from winning the U.S. Open Championship, Gloria Connors, Jimmy's mother. Connors is not going to quit.
Connors got the breaks with let cords. Now Vilas
love
has gotten
30.
It is love 30. That dancing young man right there is 2 points away from the U.S. Open Men's Singles Championship.
He'd be great at a discotheque. Pretty good at tennis, too.
Triple match point for Vilas.
And Tony Trabert, the very first night of our coverage, you picked him to win. Congratulations. That may be a little premature. Vilas had Orantes in just about this same spot 2 years ago. It is 40-love. Vilas. Love 40, Connor serving.
Let me
triple
say this.
Match point, excuse me.
It's a privilege to have been a part of this one, Pat, working with you.
Ball.
And everyone else connected with CBS to bring everyone this great championship. Still double match point for Vilas. Somebody in the crowd, just unbelievable, has to say something at this point. Let's let him play. Two match points saved by Connors. Segura on the left. Gloria Connors on the right.
30-40.
It is still match point for Guillermo Vilas.
And he's still jumping up and down.
That's out. And Jimmy Connors has gotten to deuce.
Deuce.
You can't help but think about a couple of years ago when Arantes was playing Vilas, and Vilas had him two sets to love, five love, eventually had five match points, and Arantes won.
Just walked back and clenched his fist. Advantage Connors.
Advantage Connors.
Talk about heart and talent and youth and all those things we were talking about before.
Really have to give them both a tremendous amount of credit. Talk about giving it everything you have.
Second.
And I can guarantee you that that's not choking. He was trying to get that ball deep. Make it kick up. Deuce. The fourth time, it is match point for Vilas.
Connors won the first set 6-2. Vilas came back 6-3 to even it. Then in a tiebreaker, he won. So he won the third set 7-6. The tiebreaker score was 7-4. And he leads now 5-love. What must Jimmy Connors be thinking? Tough second serve trade.
Yes, sir. He gets good loop on it, though. Good safety.
Photographers around Vilas now. I'm looking down at the other end at Ian Tyriac, and he hasn't made a move. He's just standing up and waiting. The umpire's still in a chair. I'm not sure we're through yet. Are you, Trey?
I am not either, because the linesman on the side.
Mr. Vilas wins.
Now I'm sure.
Now we are sure.
7-6, 6-love.
6-love in the fourth set. And Vilas wins. There's Jimmy Connors. He said at the beginning of the week, it is my title, they're going to have to take it. And Vilas did.
Who's North? Don't back up any further. Who's North? Let's go get a massage.
Let's give Jimmy Connors a great deal of credit, Pat. The guy's struggled, fought a questionable ending to the match. He has not argued at all. He's got his jacket on, and he's going off with his entourage, heading for the locker room. He was a defending champion. Great, great victory for Guillermo Vilas. They said he couldn't win the big one. He won the French championships earlier this year in decisive fashion. He was instrumental in beating our Davis Cup team earlier this year, and now he is the U.S. Open champion for 1977.
He said before it started, if I win this championship, maybe now they will consider me to be number one.
What a way to close out the U.S. Open at Forest Hills.
What a way to say goodbye to this stadium. Guillermo Vilas with a victory over Jimmy Connors, 3-1. Here is the shot again that closed it out. Slow it down. There was some question about this.
Hello.
That looks awfully close.
Instant replay is not really fair, but it is history. It did obviously look to us as that ball hit on the line. It would maybe not change the result. But Jimmy Connors is on his way to the locker room, and Guillermo Vilas of Argentina is the 1977 U.S. Open men's singles champion. We salute him.
As picked by Tony Trabert when this championship started. Kiriak is over close by now. There is the count. Vilas, Vilas, the chant goes up, as well it should. He lost only one set on his way to this title, the U.S. Open title, and Vilas now coming over toward the presentation stand. Tremendous champion.
The final score, 2-6, 6-3, 7-6, 6-love to Vilas.
So the crowd's now sort of halfway stunned at the fashion in which Vilas won that last set. It was 6-love. Nevertheless, he is the champion. Guillermo Vilas with the headband off, and he's just being called up. Jimmy Connors has gone. That is Slew Hester, the president of the USTA, up there with him. Just greeted by a chorus of boos because this is the last year here. So, Tony, you can't... the chant of Vilas, Vilas has been going for about 10 minutes now since he won that championship. Connors is long gone, and you can't blame him for that. Slew Hester on the right. Guillermo Vilas just shaking hands. Don't forget Tuesday night at 8 o'clock Eastern Time on CBS, Night of the Champions. And don't forget also that you'll see CBS 60 Minutes in its entirety tonight, as well as the entire CBS schedule. It'll all be moved back so that we could bring you the finals of this. All right, that is it. Vilas the champion. This is Pat Summerall along with Tony Trabert, Cliff Drysdale, and Virginia Wade saying so long from the Westside Tennis Club in Forest Hills, New York.
The 1977 U.S. Open Tennis Championships have been sponsored by the Penn Mutual Life Insurance Company. We make life insurance work for a living.